also. And then what I wanted to say today is like, I just wanted to share some analysis. One of our friend asked one query stating that the market in the zone of 2008 zone, it had a crash. Clear, it had a crash of more than 60% from 6,400 to 2,200 has been seen. So 60% of downside move is seen in Nifty in the year of 2008 to 2009. And but the high broken or the time it took to break the high, it took nearly 2 years of time. From 2008 November till 2010 November, it took nearly 2 years of time, and then only it was roaming around the high region. And what I also could say is like after that, nearly it took some 4 years or 5 years to break the high and to move further up. But there was a question over here is like, it has fallen nearly 40%, but why it is moving very fast towards the all-time high? That was the question I asked by some of my friends. So what I would say is like, just I'm not applying more of a technical, I'm just applying a logical term. So guys, see over here, from January 2008 till October 2008, that means 10 months of fall has been seen in Nifty during the period of 2008. But in the case of this time crisis, whatever we have seen, so that has taken from January 2020 till March 2020. It is just a 3 months of fall which has been seen. And even if suppose anyone wants to know about this fall also, even at the 2015 March, it took and it went till March 2016. 1 year of fall was seen over this zone. But ultimately, we have seen only 3 months of fall over this period of time. So this period of time, only 40% fall. Anyways, 40% has been fallen. And 3 months of time, 3 months of fallen only as fall has only been taken. So considering all these things, just a logical thing, it can be wrong, it cannot be wrong. I'm just sharing what I understood. So 10 months of fall took nearly 2 years of time to hit the all-time high again. And after that, breaking the all-time high took some sort of extra 3 years. Okay, from 2011 to 2014, it took extra 3 years to break. So 10 months of fall and then 2 years of all-time high, 2 years to touch the all-time high, and then next 3 years to break the all-time high and move further up. So what I would see in what I would see here is like 3 months of fall has been seen. So what I am actually expecting is within 6 months of time we will be touching the previous day high. Sorry, all-time high. So within 6 months of time means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So September, October we might touch all-time high. And if in case after that, if any consolidation, anything might happen. But still, I could see if it is not able to break, and the same way if it is able to get resistance, face resistance at the 12,400 zone, then still what I feel is that it can come back to this zone of 11,500 and then it can fly back again. So all-time high, as per my expectation, I am expecting within September, October, we might touch all-time high, which is 12,400. And after touching 12,400, if it is facing some sort of resistance, then we might see 11,500, which is nothing but a 500 points or 600 points consolidation, the sideways move, not a fall sort of thing. It can come till that zone or it can come till this zone also. Anything is possible. So 11,800 is also possible. Come to that zone or come to this zone. Any zone is possible. If that is going to happen, then we can see further upside till the movement of 13,500 to 14,000. So now the question will be like how from the all-time high to this zone of consolidation or whatever has happened, how long it will take? So that will be the question for many of the people. So that will be around 4 months maybe. So that will be about 4 months in the sense by 2020 end, we might see all-time high and then some pullback also. And after that, within another 4 or 5 months, we will be able to see the break of the upper zone. So as per the time analysis, as per my some sort of logical thinking, it might be illogical also, it might be very poor also, but forget about it. What I am trying to say is like in the 2008 crisis, the fall happened for 10 months, but the fall happened this time is for only 3 months. And what I also see is like For a 10-month fall, it took nearly 1 month to nearly 2 years to touch the all-time high again. But I would say it can take some sort of 6 months to 7 months to touch the all-time high again. So September to October or November time will be, I feel should not be used in market. But I suppose that market, as per the logical thinking, says market can touch all-time high again in the month of September, October, November. So this is what my expectation. And any small sort of pullback till 11,800 or 11,500 can happen. If that is happening, then we can see further upside move towards the all-time high getting broken. And the time period for all those things to happen is 2020, we can see all-time high and also some pullback. And before 2021, June or July, we can expect some further top break, broken up move also, like towards 13,500 or 15,000. I may be wrong. Market is always different. I just shared some logical thinking of what I could see. So this can be wrong. This cannot be wrong. I am not guaranteed of anything. So do your own analysis. Just I thought of sharing you what is the possible targets which can come for Nifty. So that is what I tried to say over here. So that's it from my end, guys. Thanks a lot, Chetan, for more videos. And once again, so do not think that, as he has told, that market is going towards 12,400 for sure. So do not say that there is not going to be any pullback. There can be any pullback. There cannot be any pullback. I'm just giving my view on a longer scale or a large scale around for some next 6 months or 1 year. So with that, do not assume to take a short-term goals for that. So this is what about, this is all about the analysis, what I wanted to share over here. If you feel the content is good, kindly give a like. If you feel it is not logical, if it is something weird or anything you wanted to say, do share me in the comment section. So that's it from my end. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.